Hi, I'm Don Calhoun.
And I'm Duane Coos, and we're co-authors of the book, How to Dance with the Elephant. Thanks for joining us today. We've got another great topic for you, and that is?
How much time do we have?
How much time do we have? Is today a good day to die, you're saying, huh?
Yeah, you remember the movie Little Big Man? I don't know if you ever remember with Dustin Hoffman, where the old chief goes up every day to the top of the hill to lay in the burial mound or whatever, and he would lay to die, and he'd always say, it's a good day to die, and then he would never die. The question is really an empowering one for our audience, Duane. And that is, how much time, what will we do? How much time do we have before we die? And what are we going to be defined by that? And so we have a little sneak peek preview that in the research of the book, will you tell them about?
Well, in writing the book, we have gone to great lengths to create numerous exercises for the reader to get actively involved. With the topics, of course, that we're presenting. And this one here we felt was close enough that we needed to share it. So we're going to share one of our favorite exercises with you today to maybe connect you closer to this aspect and concept of when am I going to die? And we call it our 9 by 21. And so here's how it lays out. Effective this moment, right now, you have 21 days left to live, and you can do any 9 things during those 21 days. And here's the only catch. You have to be able to do those 9 things in the amount of time they'll take. Case in point, Don, if you want to go to Europe in your 21 days, you better allocate probably, 14 days to that trip?
Correct. And when we did this, and it's extremely important for you to take this seriously. Don't take it lightheartedly. Because if you really ask yourself the deep, deep question, literally, I got 21 days left on this earth, what would I want to do and how would that change my paradigm and my reality? What is it what I would do? And when I did this exercise personally, I was shocked a little bit with my answers. And one of my things that I had done with my son is when on his 21st birthday, I magically sat across the country with him on a road trip and we went to see his favorite rock band, the Red Hot Chili Peppers, in Denver, and we golfed the whole way, and we went up into the mountains, and we just had a magical, magical time. It was probably one of my favorite memories of time with my son, and I realized I had never done that with my daughter. And my daughter and I share a love of the ocean. And it's hard to define that love of the ocean. We just know we both do. I mean, literally could spend hours upon hours all day out surfing. And then we also love seafood. So literally one of my 9 by 21s is immediately hop a plane, probably go to Hawaii because of waves, maybe Southern California and Big Sur, but it was definitely where we could surf. And spend the day on the ocean, and the evening would be predicated by going out and eating crab and spending time just laughing and enjoying that. Now, that literally would take a 3-day period. The importance of that is that all of us are going to have and can define how we spend our time. And literally, why wait? Why wait? This exercise is to show you the importance of living in a day-to-day thing.
When I had the chance to go through the exercise, I remember 2 or 3 distinct moments when I just broke out in tears. Literally, you know, the exercise I took serious enough that it was real for me, and as I delineated the various items. Do you remember that? I'm blubbering in tears. And one key that I remember distinctly was a relationship with my oldest son. And coincidentally, because of a series of circumstances, we had essentially severed communications. In my mind, I was playing tough love, okay, for whatever that's worth, right? But in the end, when I was faced on that day, the idea that I had 21 days left to live and my relationship with my oldest son was totally severed, that was scary. That was very scary. And so I immediately said, Don, I got to do something about this. And you helped me. And I can share with you that similar to your recommendation, that becomes your goals. In fact, that for me became a goal that I took action on literally that week.
Yeah, and so literally, folks, it's as simple as focus and energy and your prejudice and your beliefs and your stubborn behavior, in his case of his son. What is most important in your life? And when you go through this exercise, you will hopefully clearly see, as we did, what is the most important thing. It isn't the car, and it isn't the home, and it isn't what type of motorcycle you drive or any of those things in life. It is our human connection, our capacity to love, and those people in our life literally became important. So each of you are going to have the questions to ask you, nine important things in 21 days. And hopefully that will lead you to a magical, magical sense of focus.
And I'll leave you with a connection that this has made for me, that you'll have to take it for what it's worth in terms of it comes from my heart and soul. But because of that journey, today is a good day to die. Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed today's information and would like to receive 20 free videos,
20 free videos that cover the key questions that people usually ask about dancing with the elephant, you can go to dancewiththeelephant.com.